Hello everyone and welcome to Panto Vlog number 4 with me, the Dame. Obviously this is the first vlog since Plan B, so masks. Today's task for me is to get my costumes all altered, so I look beautiful. Costume 1 is altered now. As a sneak peek of costume 1, now we're on to costume 2. Okay, we've adjusted an outfit.
Looks fabulous, I love it.
And a little sneak peek, those are my custom made wigs. Ooh, sassy.
Fun.
There's costume fitting, I think, number 3 for me. Done. There's a big pile there.
Oh no.
Loads of stuff, and Pat's lost all the bells. We're just going to quickly work on a sash, and then I shall rejoin the rest of the cast. What you doing for the holidays?
Working.
You're what? Working?
I'm working.
Just like Christmas.
I'm working.
What are you doing?
I'm off out for a meal with my family, and I'm opening Christmas presents.
What are you doing for Christmas?
I'm going to be Mars.
Your Mars. What are you doing for Christmas?
Hosting it.
Hosting it?
Yeah, we're hosting Christmas.
Oh, I thought you said posting it. I was like, where are you sending Christmas? What are you doing for Christmas?
I will be cooking and cleaning. Yeah.
Sounds fun. Well, what are you doing for Christmas, peeps?
3 Christmas dinners all in one day. It's a very busy Christmas.
Greedy.
Eating lots of nice food and making lots of wreaths.
What are you doing for Christmas?
Me?
No, the other person stuff.
Oh,
right,
sorry.
Now.
What am I doing for Christmas? Learning my lines for this. Yeah.
See, he hasn't learned them already, whereas most of us already have.
Ridiculous. We're just pros.
If we look over there, we see you, the idiots, making a fool of themselves.
Just pipe a thick line.
Oh no! Tracy, you jinxed it!
So now I've just got to decorate it.
Whoa!
They think I'm doing a madness!
Look at that icicle, people!
I am an artiste! Right, well. Really annoys me now that I've done that wall on the wrong side. Do you know what? I'm just not even going to focus on that wall. We're just going to view my house. We're just going to view my house from that angle. And ignore that that exists. Maybe I just get the rest of the ice and just say it was a snowstorm. So this side, I've decided, I just want people to know who this is. Just ruined my name.
I'm a bit undone.
I think that's as good as I'm getting. Yeah, no, I just kind of was like, I saw an opportunity.
So, Izzy, it's your turn. There are 2 gingerbread houses here. You have to vote for which one is the best. One was made by me, one was made by Fran. I'm not telling you which one was made by whom. Pick. Which one is your winner?
This one. I'm going to have to give this one
because
it looks like tiny icicles.
Absolutely. I'm not going to tell you who made which one.
Even though it's pretty obvious. I'm going to go with that one because I like the standy up bit.
And India, which one do you think wins?
To
say which one you think wins.
That one.
Oh, brilliant. That's 4-1 to me currently.
They're practically identical.
But you have to vote which one you prefer.
Well, these ones have these like gummy sweets.
Yeah.
I'm going to vote for that one.
Brilliant. So, okay, that's 5-1. Which one?
One?
You like that one?
Yeah.
Brilliant. He did point to this one. That clearly was not made by me, but it was. If you have not voted, there is the great gingerbread bake-off. You have to vote. One was made by me, one was made by Fran.
Oh, I only just realised. Okay, I vote Phil's.
This one?
Yeah.
So that's one,
yeah.
Two, that's three, yeah. Four, five. So that's 11-1, and you're going for France, so that's 11-2. And we have a pirate ship! Yeah, so this is the Jolly Roger. How's rehearsals going for you?
I have to be very honest, I genuinely, that may sound strange, but I'm genuinely surprised by how good it's already looking.
So we've got a plank of wood, we've got some stuff. This show is coming together. Today I think we're doing all the ship work. Look, we've got a campfire down there. And this is just the stuff we can get in the studio. Wait till you see the main stuff that we're saving for January. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the vlog. This is a little intercut section because I just wanted to talk a little bit seriously, which is unusual for these vlogs, but I wanted to talk to everyone that's watching these videos. The past 2 years, nearly 2 years, have been a really challenging time for everyone, and it's posed a real serious threat to everyone's mental health. Here at the Riverhead, we are a community theatre, and that means that we need to look out for our community. Tonight, as I'm recording this, Boris has tightened the restrictions once again, probably leaving a lot of people watching these videos uneasy, maybe scared of what's to come, further restrictions, who knows what. And we are here too, you know. We don't know what's going to happen in January. We don't know if there's more restrictions to come, whether the show can even go ahead, but you know, we're plowing on as best we can. We're going to do our part to make sure that come January, everything is as close to normal as possible. But in the meantime, I want everyone watching these videos to just do one thing for me, and that is look after yourselves. If you are feeling anxious, stressed out, worried, scared, alone, whatever it is, if you are not feeling well, please reach out, talk to someone. There is someone out there that will help you. We all need to kind of work together in this day and age. Please don't suffer in silence, just reach out to someone. And I'm gonna keep doing my best to entertain people in these vlogs or other videos on this channel or whatever it can be. Hopefully take your mind off the stress of the world. And who knows, hopefully in January we can all be back here in this very foyer having a chat about how great the show was. Hopefully it was great. But yeah, I just want to put that out there. Please look after yourselves. Are we seeing the wild sharks?
Bounce. Very traumatic.
We are slightly outnumbered.
Not just slightly.
And the height issue.
Are you having a go at my height? Are you making fun of my height?
I don't know. I was more thinking him.
I have never seen before. I'm tired of these city streets.
We're going to reveal the competition winners now. I've got a list of everything, and basically they're going to pick random numbers. That's going to reveal who wins. Let's start with the main prize. Laura, give me a number.
Number 12.
Well done, George Ma. You've won the main thing. Now for the five other ones.
23.
Whoa. 23, Cy Jones, well done. Number?
5.
5. Rachel Pudsey, Jack.
Yay. Yay.
7.
Amanda Parker, well done.
19.
Two more to go. 19.
Is that you again?
Amanda Williams, 2 Amandas, hey. Back to back.
10.
I'm sorry, Rachel, you're not winning twice.
2.
Jay Blanchard! Yay. There we go.
Hey guys, I hope you've enjoyed the vlog so far. It's kind of been a mishmash of loads of footage that I've had for a long time. The gingerbread thing, we did a joke off which didn't work as a video, so I've included some of that in the montage. A makeup challenge, loads of stuff, and it's all kind of been thrown into this video. Because it's all been with the Panto crew and cast, which has been a load of fun to film. So I hope you've enjoyed it all. For our competition winners, there'll be the email in the description. If you just email that saying your name and that you have won one of the prizes, and then we will send you an email back with all the information we need. We'll need to know like what night you're coming in, all that kind of stuff. And we will organise all of your prizes. In the video, we sang happy birthday to John. It was his birthday on one of the rehearsals, so we obviously surprised him with that. And me and Spen were told to distract John whilst they set that up. So the final clip of this vlog is going to be how me and Spen distracted him. Here you go. Okay, so that is the end of today's vlog, but to tell you all the information about this show and how you can book tickets, here is the director and Captain Hook.
Date the pantomime
are as follows: Friday the 7th to Sunday the 16th of January 2022. Times vary, just turn up when you feel like it, alright. With a relaxed performance on Sunday the
16th of January, 11 a.m. performance, yes.
I'll be slightly calmer and there'll be less noise and mayhem.
Booking is available online at www.louthriverheadtheatre.com, or you can call the box office on 01507 600 350, open Monday to Saturday, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m.
And how much are tickets?
Tickets, according to this, I think they're free. One moment, please.
No, they're not.
Yeah, be quiet. Try to concentrate. No, there's no price on here, so turn up, make a donation. No, don't really.
We're going to auction them off seat by seat. Yes.
I'll put the price down here for you.
Yes, it's down there.
But yeah, until next time. See ya. Bye.